Yes, everybody, welcome to a brand new morning. This is actually 5 o'clock in the morning. Why in God's name am I doing a podcast at 5 o'clock in the morning, do you ask? Well, I just felt like it. Anyway, I just want to tell you guys, I don't know if you guys have heard this guy. This guy is on StoryFire. It's getting a lot of steam. Well, not really steam, but a lot of, a lot of advertisement to the thing. The latest to the StoryFire is endorsements. Now, if you know anything about endorsements, that means anybody besides yourself that could endorse your social media website to your app. Anybody who's out there who is a big player out there can endorse your platform is great in my books. No matter what. So anyway, StoryFire, if you don't know, is gaining traction. And I'm not just saying that to hear myself. This guy, better known as Jesse Ridgway, he's the guy who I think is developed this app called StoryFire. Basically, it was supposed to be where you do storytelling. It didn't work out that way for him at all. It really didn't. Really, really didn't. It was an app that you could tell stories at a campfire. StoryFire. So a lot of people joined up StoryFire as of this year, since January. So yeah, Jesse Ridgway, which is better known as Juggernuckers or Juggernux. You guys will probably go upload the app or the website. Okay, it's called StoryFire.com. You only heard that once, but you're going to hear when I upload this this audio portion. So go to StoryFire.com. A lot of people are going on there for many, 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 many reasons. It was basically an app that tells story. It's like storytelling about your story. And, when you sign on to there, you got to have a story. Something to do a story that you want to put on there, on your on StoryFire. It's kind of like a replacement to YouTube. Let me just say that again. It's a replacement to YouTube. Now, don't get your head in the wraps. Because remember, this is StoryFire. It's not going to replace YouTube. Don't get your heads around it. It's gonna be competing with YouTube. Essentially, another social media site out there. So you can put stuff on there. But basically, it was the original idea of the StoryFire app and website was to do stories, storytelling. People would say, oh, let's do storytelling. Let's tell a story about your video and what you put on there. Let's do storytelling. Documents to you name it on the platform. So the way you do that, you need to get endorsements, the big guys out there, to endorse your StoryFire or whatever platform you're endorsing with. Any apps out there that you really want people to be on there and endorse you heavily, very heavily. Really, really give it a boost, give it a kind of like a boost of, they call it the word of mouth. The word of mouth on social media is kind of like the word of mouth on social media. You get the ball rolling, the snowball effect going. It's like hearsay. Oh, I heard that app saying StoryFire. Let's go on there. Let's download the app. Let's go onto the website, and let's really say. And a lot of people are kind of peeved about StoryFire. I'm not going to put my 2 cents in it. They're not really peeved. They're just telling what Jesse. Well, there's a lot of things that are kind of shake your head about on the StoryFire. You have to send an application. 6 months you have to, and then they'll endorse your videos up in there. So, this is what I'm saying, folks. Like I said, this is not going to replace YouTube at all. It's not going to replace YouTube. YouTube's not going to replace StoryFire. It's just another player out in the social media world. Just another player, another social media. It's like Facebook to Twitter, or Twitter to Facebook. It's just another social media site that people can go on and link to. Remember, they always tell you out there, just link it. Just link your website. It's kind of like linking. You ever heard the word called link it? Just share the links, share the links. Well, this is what I mean. StoryFire needs to start sharing links to their StoryFire to YouTube. And that's the gets, it's called linking it. It's called linking it. You know, the whole notion to that is linking it, sharing it. So you'll hear that in a lot of people on a lot of social media sites about linking that. What can we link that website, or can we get the UR on that? They'll go through computer phrases or words they'll say to it. Say, can you link this? Can I share it on my social media platform? Can I endorse this? Can I, a lot of things that you want to endorse this heavily, because you're a big player in a big pond, or a little player in a big pond. So you're just gradually getting your subscriber base to your people on the platform, essentially. You're gathering steam, is what they'll say. You're gathering steam to be a big player in the game, or a little guy in the pond to the bigger player in the world. YouTube is already out there. It's been there since 2006, if you can believe it. 2006. So YouTube is just what I'm saying is just a video service. I've been saying it for a long time, a video service, where you, as a user, this is based on users, you can upload your videos many times, as long as you want, whatever you need to do. Either production videos to your whatever, go live streaming on it, to whatever you can think of on YouTube. The world's your oyster. And essentially, the player gets about to come in this social media genre, the websites and everything, is they call it the little player from the big player standpoint. Like, YouTube is the big player on every social media site out there already. You got Facebook, you got Twitter, you got YouTube, you got a whole bunch of social media sites just clamming for attention, essentially. Clamming for your attention to have the big player in your social media genre. Now endorsements are good. Sometimes if you get endorsements, the big player in the pond, you're essentially on your way to making great content. You're trying to endorse a lot of people out there to get on your social media website or app. That's Android app to your iOS apps. So bear this in mind, everybody. So anyway, here's the really big news. The really big news. Now you heard from Owen Sawyer from War Room on InfoWars. Remember that station called InfoWars with Alex Jones and the big player in the game? Alex Jones, who you know from InfoWars, he does the news. I still can't forget. I still don't know what InfoWars really means to anybody. I mean, I've been listening to Alex Jones for a long time. I still don't know what InfoWars really was meant for. And you got a bunch of players in there. You got Owen Sawyer, you got David McKnight, or whatever his name is, to Alex Jones. A lot of people know Alex Jones, will know what he is, what he stands for and everything. Now, where he gets his money is through the endorsements. Well, not really endorsements, but products that he sells on his social media sites. You get products. So it's a listener-based InfoWars. It's not, they don't get big money from government. No big money, no enchilada. So the whole notion of that is you gotta get your products on there. Really get products on there, like heavily. Products like a merch, they call merchandise. If you ever heard of business things in the world today, it's called merchandising. You gotta put your product out there, promote it heavily. If you don't want to, you don't need to. This is not for everybody, remember that. It's not for everybody. But if you want your site to be promoted, by anybody. Jesse Witchway promoted it heavily. I mean, he has the merchandise for it. So you'll see him around. If you see him around, he's basically promoting his StoryFire website that people could go on to. Just heavily, I mean, very heavily. Just go out there and just promote the heck of it. Saying that you're kind of like the little guy in the big pond, just climbing for attention out there. And so bear with me. Just bear with me, okay, folks? So, yeah, you got Owen Sawyer, big endorsements here. This is big news and coming from InfoWars. Big endorsements, everybody. This is very big. You got Owen Sawyer going to go on the platform called StoryFire. And yeah, and people are saying, what does this mean? Well, what it really means is you got a big player coming into your social media platform, such as Owen Sawyer from InfoWars, from the War Room. And Alex Jones, who you, a lot of people, no matter if you like him or hate him, he's there on InfoWars. And yes, InfoWars, but they do products there that the people who actually try the products, they swear by that it's really good. I never tried the products, but the people who buy these products on InfoWars, I think it was InfoWarsStore.com thing, and really go on there, and people are swear by it. It's good. It's great. They swear by it, but I never tried the products. I've heard someone on YouTube videos that actually tried the product, and he didn't like it. Any of those products that he mentioned on InfoWars. There's kind of like, they use the natural stuff. They use the natural stuff, if you know what I mean. Sometimes with the pharmaceutical drugs, it's not always great. I do mean not great. But here's Alex Jones coming into to the world and saying this, their products are really good. They use the old natural stuff from around the world, and they're not kidding. So they use the natural stuff, and you believe me? That's what I'm saying. So Owen Sawyer is now on StoryFire. I'm going to put that in the big title on this podcast on YouTube. I'm going to upload it to YouTube. There you go, folks. So big player is now came on to StoryFire. Now you have all the reason to be on StoryFire. So that's a big endorsement. It just, when I saw the video, it kind of told me a big endorsement. Because you got a guy from InfoWars. These are one of these InfoWars reporters. And a big pond. So bear that in mind. So a little guy from a big pond. Big player in the social media genre. And he's publicizing this heavily. So bear this in mind, folks. This is going to be great. Now, it's not for everybody to be on StoryFire, but Jesse is promoted heavily. You'll know, people are saying, is that what he looks like on camera? He does really. I'm not kidding. There's a few people that met him, and were asking if that's what he looks like on camera. I kid you not, that's what he looks like on camera. If you ever meet him. But yeah, so anyway, Jesse along with his brother are on StoryFire. A whole bunch of them were on StoryFire last month or so. Bear this in mind, I think they said it's been around since 2017? So anyway, that's all I have to say, folks. I'll publicize it here on my YouTube channel. And yeah, so I'll still be on YouTube no matter what. And StoryFire is also on YouTube. You just have to type in StoryFire in the search engines of YouTube. And you get some great videos there. And yeah, these are based on users. And they pay you for the... Apparently you can get paid. Put your videos up there, you get paid. Can you believe this? Getting paid for your own videos up there. Well, yeah, YouTube doesn't pay their users, but StoryFire does, apparently. So, anyway, take it as you will. You don't have to be on that platform. I'm saying to all you people, you don't have to be on that platform. Just hear what I'm saying. If it's not for you or it's not for anybody else, don't be on it. But if you want to be on there, be on there. This is your option. I'm giving people options here. I like to give people options because I don't want to, you know, give them a raw idea that you have to be on there. It's your option. If you want to look at it, that's fine. If you don't want to look at it, you don't have to sign to it. You don't have to. A big endorsement just recently was Owen Sawyer from War Room, from on InfoWars. So that's a big endorsement, everybody. I was surprised. Big endorsements, and I'm not kidding, folks. So there you go. But what does this mean? We don't know. But Jesse Ridgway is actually the latest video. He was going to buy an office. He's going to buy an office that would have StoryFire written top of the office thing. So it's going to create steam. It's going to create. He's doing what he needs to do to order to get the word out there. It's not just YouTube. It's not just Twitter. It's not just Facebook. People are fed up with Facebook. Are going to be trying on go on to StoryFire. I'll mention that on the title. Okay, just bear that in mind. So anyway, I'll see you guys on the next episode. Thank you very much. Oh, by the way, I'm not going to say hit that like button, subscribe to my channel. You can subscribe to my channel and hit that like button if you're on YouTube. Doesn't matter where you are. Just if you like my videos, that's fine. You don't have to listen to them if you don't want to. But, yeah, so anyway, that's all. 5 o'clock in the morning. I'm sorry I'm doing this 5 o'clock early in the morning. This is like Eastern Standard Time, folks. A.M. in the morning. This is like witching hour, almost. So, anyway, guys, the next episode is going to be talked about time traveling, or a teleportation. I almost forget how to spell it, or say it, actually. Teleportation, a lot of people say they have time machines out there. But anyway, that's the next episode. Until then, I'll see you guys on the next podcast. Until then, yours truly, Dave Nation, a.k.a. Dave Nation, alias name, Dave Nation. And, yeah. Anyway, see you guys all back on the next episode. If you like my videos and audio stuff, be sure to hit that like button. Do what you have to do, okay? Until then, ciao.